Today, I'm going to share with you 7 important facts to start your business in Malaysia. Now, if you are thinking of starting your business, then you must watch this video till the end. Number one, you will not become super rich immediately or overnight. Now, there's a lot of people think that, hey, I want to become an entrepreneur so that I become billionaires like Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos from Amazon, Jack Ma for Alibaba. Now, you can become like them one day, but not immediately. So first thing, we got to aware that to become an entrepreneur is not a get-rich-quick scheme, right? So do not think that immediately when I go in, I will make lots and lots of money. So that's a wrong misconception to become an entrepreneur. Second thing, now, this may discourage you to become an entrepreneur because what I'm going to tell you is the hard truth. So the second thing is to become an entrepreneur or start your own business require real work. It doesn't mean that today you can start an online business, click a few buttons and start making money. No, it is not like that. You need to put in real work. Even though, yeah, a lot of work can be done through computer if you are doing online business, but it's still real work. You need to build your website, you need to build your sales funnel, you need to run ads, and sometimes you need to go and find products, joint ventures, work with other people. And if you are doing e-commerce, in the beginning, if you do not have workers work for you, you still need to go out and deliver your products. So all these are real work. Doesn't mean that now I become an online marketer or have my own e-commerce business. I can click a few buttons and just make money from there. So the real business requires real work. Now, the third things I want you to know is that you will always have competitions or competitors. So do not think that your products or your services are one and only unique in the world. Now, if it's that one and only in the world, then you have another problem as well, because nobody knows about that. Then you got to spend a lot of time and money to go and promote and educate your potential customers about your products. But in real life, most of the products or your services, you will have competition, and that is fine. So do not think that, hey, I do not want to do anything with high competition. No matter what products or services that you have, you will have competitors. Of course, there are some very high competition and some are lower competition. So if you can go into those that are lower competitions, then that will be fine. Or you can use a blue ocean strategy to strategize how to go into a highly competitive market. So it all depends on what products or services that you have. Fourth is you need to master sales and marketing, especially when you just start up. So even though you will have the best products or services in the world, if you do not know how to do sales and marketing, nobody will know your products or services. You know, I learned this the hard way 20 plus years ago when I first started my consulting business. And worse that is I am a purchasing manager, and most of the time, salespeople are begging me for sales. And now when I first start my business, I have to become a salesman to go back for sales. So I learned it the hard way that sales and marketing is very important, especially for entrepreneurs when you first start up. So my advice is learn and master sales and marketing if you want your startup business to be successful. And remember, sales and marketing doesn't mean that when I say back means that you got to go and pull someone's legs and back for sales. But today, to me, sales and marketing is more about how to educating your customers or potential customers to get them interested in your products. So you got to portray yourself as an expert for your products or services. Now, interested to learn more about expert marketing, follow these channels because I'm going to share weekly business or marketing tips in this channel. Number five facts is that there is no guarantee of success. So do you still want to be an entrepreneur? Now, do you see, entrepreneur world is very different from working for other people, like in an employment. Entrepreneur world is focusing on getting results. It is not like you go to work for someone or some company and you just work hard for 30 days and you get a salary. But if you're running your business, you can work very hard for 30 days It doesn't mean that you will get profits. Worse still, sometimes you will get losses. For example, single day 11/11 just over, and you can see that a lot of people selling a lot of products. Now, after selling the products, they have busy packing, shipping out the products, tracking it, answering, do customer service. So they are very busy, working very hard on their business. But it doesn't mean that they will make money. And a lot of all these sales and great bargain during the single day sales, they are making losses. But don't get me wrong, because all these companies who does that, usually they have a good marketing strategy to later earn more profits. This is one of the marketing strategy acquire customers. But I want to tell you is that there's no guarantee of success even if you work hard in this business. So number six is get a mentor. So the best way to learn to start up and guarantee success is to find someone who already done that, who has the experience to achieve the things that you want to achieve right now. That way you will cut short a lot of your trial and errors, because trial and errors are cost. Now in my entrepreneur journey, I also have a lot of mentors that are helping me achieve my business goals in different areas. So I highly recommend go find a mentor that can help you. Just remember to find the mentor who has the real experience so that you can follow their footsteps and learn from them. Number seven is like just now what I say, you need to have a practical business strategy. Why I say practical? Because practical means that it depends on your situation. You can't just copy someone else's business strategy and apply to your business unless your business environment and background is the same. So it is important to develop your own personalized strategies that will help you. The key thing to have a good practical business strategy is to look at your target market, what kinds of products or services that you provide, or what offers do you provide to this target market, and as well as what is your capital or marketing budget promote your business. So these are all important elements in building a great practical business strategy for your business. Now, if you just start out your business or you are growing your offline business to an online world, I would like to help you so that you can build your business successfully online. Head on to description below. I put a link for you to book a 30-minute strategy sessions with me where I will go through and help you to develop a practical business strategy that will suit your business. Now, if you're serious, you're interested, just head down below and click the link and book a session, and it is free for you. There are only limited slots. So if you're serious, just head on and click on the link and book your session. Now, I hope these seven tips will help you to get a better, clearer picture when you want to start your business or to grow your business online. By the way, if you have not subscribed to this channel, do click on the subscribe button right now and turn on the notification bell so that every week when we publish new content, you will be notified. And meanwhile, these are the videos that I've created to help you grow your business online. This is Andrew. I'll see you real soon in my next video.